during this year, the rate of inflation should not, you know, should come down sharp. My heart, as a Nigerian, hopes so. My head, as an economist, tells me it can happen. And the reason is not because we don't want it to happen, but don't ever forget that there is always a lag between what, don't make the assumption that what we did and ended in 2016 ends its impact in 2016. Some of that impact will carry through into 2017. And one of, I'm sure those of you who have had a chance to read my MPC statement from November 2016 will have seen my complaints, or at least my, that I noted the sharp increase in liquidity that has happened. That sharp increase in liquidity will work its way through the system over a period of time. Now, so that's a fundamental challenge. The second thing that we should also not forget is that we need to be patient. I'm now going back to a couple of things. They draw attention to manufacturing and all of that. On paper, we have one of the best exchange rate systems in the world. The policies that were announced in June 2016. But the constraints on the supply side mean we have not been able to implement that regime the way we would have liked. And so we still got a significant FX constraint. And that shows up in manufacturing very significantly. Indeed, when you look at Nigeria's GDP numbers, six sectors account for 80% of this economy's output. And so if anything goes wrong with those six sectors, no matter what you do, the numbers are in trouble. Now, six sectors, of them, really only two are in growth mode. Agriculture, which is growing at about 5%, I think it was 4.5. And ICT, agriculture is 23% of the economy, ICT is about 10-11%. But ICT, which is essentially telecoms, was growing at about 1% in quarter three. So, pretty much all the other big sectors are in trouble. Oil and gas is about 10% of the economy, and it has seen a sharp decline. One of the assumptions on which any growth in 2016 is based is that oil and gas will recover some of its spoils. And I think the government is making a very good case of reconnecting with the Niger Delta to ensure peace, calm in the Niger Delta in order to be able to stimulate production. And so you can have a basis for assuming oil sector will improve. And Nigeria, fortunately, has also been excluded from the OPEC cuts in production numbers. So, okay. As long as the climatic conditions don't really worsen, agriculture should also deliver. So, I can already see where 0.6% growth will come from. But the other key sectors, manufacturing, these are some of those sectors that continue to show the impact of the supply side challenges to FX. And the key question will be, how will we resolve that in 2017? Answer, well, it's going to be difficult. Because after, do the numbers, and they're not difficult to do. Today, NYMEX is at about 56. The NYMEX, by the way, is the New York Mercantile Exchange. It's about futures markets, about 55, 56. So let's even assume $60 a barrel of oil, the average price of oil in 2017. I said about the delta resting. Calm. So do 2.2 million barrels of crude every day on average. You're looking at about $50 billion of export revenues of oil. In 2013, we did 97, of which 90 was from oil. And so the question is this, what kinds of adjustments must we now make when oil is $60, even though it has risen from the lows of almost $27 a barrel that it had fallen to in 2015, 2016. Now, are we making those assumptions? Sorry, are we making those adjustments? These adjustments really do need to be made. Nigeria must come to an understanding that we are not where we used to be, and so we cannot continue to live the way we used to. I've been challenged to say, okay, so how do we stimulate investment? And I'm clear in my analysis and my conclusions. Just think about this. 36 state governments and one federal government, 37. FG 7.3 trillion in 2017 proposed. States, 33 of them have released their budgets, have released their budget proposals for 2017. They amount to about 6.5 trillion. So between all of them, they are talking of about 13, just close to 14 trillion. The Nigerian Infrastructure Master Plan requires Nigeria to spend 30 trillion every year for 30 years, started in 2013. And so if anybody assumes that government money is what will power infrastructure at the level of expansion, upgrade, and maintenance that we require, I don't think that's likely. So in other words, if all of them contribute all their money, don't pay salaries, don't do anything, just build good quality infrastructure, it's less than a third of what is required annually. And so, whether we like it or not as a country, my view is we are going to have to find a way of attracting and retaining investment capital from the private sector. It doesn't matter whether it's indigenous private sector or international private sector, into sectors that are critical for our development, especially infrastructure. Imagine if you were to put a decent network of rail. It creates new corridors of activity, new corridors of growth. Imagine what has happened to us as a result of telecoms. Information whizzes around the economy much faster. It reduces the cost of doing business. And so these are some of those issues that fundamentally make it a very bright prospect for Nigeria if we were to go in this kind of direction. Somebody, a friend, was talking to me yesterday about, oh,